Hello friends, welcome to this video on constructions. In our previous video, we learned some basic constructions such as angle bisector, perpendicular bisector and construction of an angle of a given measure. Additionally, we also learned to depict them in mathematical form. Friends, in the previous classes, we have learned the general construction of triangles, such as the construction of a triangle when the length of all its sides is given, construction of a triangle when the length of its two sides and the measure of the angle between them is given, construction of a triangle when the measure of its two angles and the length of the side in between them is given, and the construction of a right-angled triangle when the length of its one side and its hypotenuse is given. In this session, we will learn the construction of a triangle given its base, a base angle and the sum of the other two sides. So, as an example, let's construct a triangle PQR. Here, we are given the length of the base QR, the measure of the base angle, angle Q, and the sum of the other two sides, that is QP plus PR. For the construction of a triangle, information of three parts is essential. Here, information of three parts of triangle is given. Think, is this information sufficient for the construction of a triangle? Yes, and the steps for the construction of such a triangle are as follows. Step 1. First of all, with the help of a scale, draw a line segment QR equal to the length of the given base. Step 2. Now, by placing the protractor on ray QR from point Q, by constructing an angle AQR equal to the given measure, draw ray QA. Then, with the help of a scale, taking the measurement equal to the sum of the length of the two sides, with the help of a compass, draw an arc on ray QA. Let's name this point as point B. Step 4. Now, let's join point B and point R. Step 5. Now, measuring angle RBQ with the help of a protractor, constructing an angle equal to angle RBQ on side RB from point R, draw a ray RC. Then, name the point of intersection of side QA and side RC as point P. Friends, pause the video and think, why do we construct angle RBQ is equal to angle BRC? We need side PR equal to side PB. Therefore, we construct the isosceles triangle for which two angles need to be equal. Hence, in the constructed figure, triangle PQR is the required triangle which we wanted to construct. Now, we will verify the figure drawn. In triangle BPR, in construction, we made two equal angles, angle PBR and angle PRB. Therefore, angle PBR is equal to angle PRB. Triangle BPR is an isosceles triangle because two of its angles are equal and opposite sides of equal angles in an isosceles triangle are equal in length. So side PR will be equal to side PB. Let's call it equation 1. Side PQ and side PB together form side BQ. Therefore, we will write it like this. Using equation 1. Hence, the sum of the other two sides is equal to the sum of the other two constructed sides. Therefore, the construction done is correct. So friends, that's all in this session. In this session, we learned the construction of a triangle given its base, a base angle, and the sum of the other two sides. This video ends here. See you in the next video with some questions based on this construction. Thank you.